Normally, if we are speaking about big, rowdy and loud crowds in wrestling, we are usually referring to places like New York, Chicago and sometimes Philadelphia, with the UK crowd being a yearly special occasion for the Crazy Fans Award. But now, for the second year in a row, WWE held Backlash overseas with a relatively mid to average pay-per-view card, but with an audience louder than stadiums. First, we had Puerto Rico in 2023, a crowd that turned an entrance into a concert for a few minutes and was on fire all night. We all thought WWE couldn't get a more passionate crowd for a PLE after that, but friend said, hold my croissant. I think I speak for every wrestling fan in the world when I say the French crowd at Backlash this year proved more than ever that we need a WrestleMania overseas and why WWE needs to air more international events. The crowd in Lyon will most likely be the best crowd in the history of wrestling up to that point. Never before have I been invested into a show just because of the crowd. The card had the drawing power for a Z to B PLE at max, but Lyon made it their personal WrestleMania. Their passion transferred through the TV and it made me do things I wouldn't normally do while watching wrestling. I admit I had a good drink before the show, but goddamn, when the show started and Randy Orton was doing his entrance, I got goosebumps while singing his song along, and not just for one or two lines. No. The entire hook was sung. With that atmosphere and with that opening, turning the match into a street fight was even more hype than it already was before, and I admit, the tag team match between the Bloodline and Randy Orton and Kevin Owens had no right to be this awesome. Great spots, great chemistry, great ending. I just can't wait how the Bloodline story continues. Now, after such a strong start, you think the crowd needs to cool down a bit. They still have 2.5 hours left, right?
Not this time. Wrong.
They kept up their voices and they made the triple threat match for the women's championship feel like these three women are the biggest stars of not only their division, but WWE as a whole. And it turns out, they wouldn't stop there. Damian Priest vs. Jey Uso for the World Heavyweight Championship under normal circumstances would be hot enough for either a big Raw main event or a small part of a PLE. It's a match you wouldn't want to put on, let's say, SummerSlam or Royal Rumble, as you have more important stars to showcase. But when Jey Uso made his entrance and over 11,000 people were yeeting along with him, Jey Uso truly had the main event aura around him, and it made me reconsider if WWE wouldn't actually put the belt around his waist because of how fucking over this guy is.
Best in the business.
Yeah, Jey going toe to toe now with Priest.
If Jey would have won right then and there, I wouldn't have been mad for a second. But Damian Priest has a more important show to work as champion, and Backlash wasn't it. That is going to be Clash at the Castle in Scotland, and oh boy, do I wanna see that show already. Now, normally the penultimate main event is a match designed to get the crowd to cool down a bit, and the Women's Tag Team Championship match was no exception. But friends, of course, held their promise and were chanting and were invested nonetheless. But they achieved the very thing WWE wanted. They made Jade Cargill exactly feel like the star WWE wants us to feel. The tag team with Bianca Belair was exactly what she needed, and it is a great fit. Plus, they get history for their eventual dream match, and Lyon made that groundwork possible. They put the finish over so hard, it made the women's tag titles instantly more important. Absolutely phenomenal. And speaking of phenomenal, what in the ever-living fuck was that main event. After almost 3 hours, the fans in Lyon were chanting and singing like they just arrived. The entrances and the announcements felt like they were bigger and more important than WrestleMania. They made the fucking hard cam shake during AJ Styles' introduction because of how rowdy and loud they were. And not only that, they actually sang Cody's theme songs to the finish. No song in the background, just the fans doing their job and applauding themselves. I mean, what can I say? What the fuck? Never before and most likely never again for a long time will a atmosphere of that magnitude be matched. Cody vs. Styles was a good match, but the crowd really gave it the big time feel, and this is something that can be said for the entire show. The all made Backlash feel like WrestleMania, probably because for us Europeans, a PLE is on par with WrestleMania. We haven't gotten any PLEs in the history of WWE, except the ones in the UK, but now with France, Scotland and even Germany on the calendar, I truly hope WWE and Triple H will think about a WrestleMania in Europe. France showed exactly what we Europeans can do and how important a passionate crowd is. Lyon didn't hijack the show by chanting stupid shit to entertain themselves rather than watching what is going on in the ring like in the past. The crowd was so invested, every count, every move, every punch had some sort of a reaction. Their song for AJ Styles wasn't just a random song, it was a song about how AJ Styles truly is phenomenal. They switched from chanting a song to counting a pin within a second, and their Simply 2 chant was absolutely hilarious. It gave the matches so much life and energy, it will be close to impossible for the US crowds to get even near that level. When WWE comes to Berlin, I truly hope that the fans are going nuts and that they all let out their football passion for a wrestling PLE in Germany. Give us a WrestleMania in Europe, I beg you, you'd be making money like hell, I promise. But what do you guys think? Should WWE put more events like Backlash overseas, or should they stick to the US? Write it down in the comments, and thank you guys so much for this short video. My name is Wiper Warfare, and I see you all in the next video. See ya.